causes of this accident. In this accident, there are three categories of causes. Root causes. Causes of leakage. Causes of fire spread. Root causes. Ignoring accidents and near misses. The repetition of leakage from these three pumps caused the leakage be considered as a simple issue and insignificant event. So, the fire accident of pump A occurred on 2 weeks ago was not enough motive and no effective action was taken to prevent the similar accident. High-risk repair work turned into routine. Weaknesses in the pump design calculations, as well as the purchase of non-original mechanical seals, caused mechanical seals to be replaced 5 times a year instead, every 3 years. Therefore, this high-risk repair work turned into routine. Failure to follow the change management requirements. Since these valves were 32 and 20 inches manual, for moving the thread up and down, the hand wheel must be turned about 24 times. This work took more than an hour for each valve, and to simplify that, an electrical motor gearbox was used to open and close the valve without any standard instructions. Lack of experienced worker and qualified equipment. The use of handmade blind flange in this complex had become quite common, and also the electrical gearbox motor could not be adjusted to close the valve completely, and there were not enough manual gearboxes for all valves. The use of inexperienced and unskilled repairmen for cost saving is another example of this root cause. Failure to follow the maintenance and repair requirements and permit to work system. For any repair work, an instruction must be prepared. According to the risks involved, presence of the repair manager is required for inspection and safe operation. According to the mechanical insulation instructions, the standard blind flange should be fully bolted. Indeed, work permit had been issued for replacing the electric motor of pump C with manual gearbox, but at the time of the work, the gearbox of pump A was removed without any work permit. Production-oriented. Lack of attention to safety requirements, procurement of substandard materials, lack of maintenance and operational equipment, ignore the warnings of operators and production-oriented cause the complex staff didn't pay attention to a high-risk activity and think that if they stop a dangerous activity, they will be reprimanded instead of being encouraged. Causes of leakage spread. On the day of the accident, which was holiday, experienced repairmen were not present in the complex, so it was decided to invite a person with little experience and salary to open the valve. Due to the lack of instructions, he was asked to remove the manual gearbox from the valve that isolated the line and replace the electric motor gearbox that was installed on the failed pump. In the past, this replacement did not cause leakage. Perhaps the reason was that when a manual gearbox was removed from a valve to install an electric motor gearbox, the corresponding pump was connected to the pipeline, and as a result, no leakage occurred. But on the day of the accident, opening and closing the manual gearbox had not been investigated, and the unskilled repairman had not any information about the accident had occurred 2 days ago. So, he started to remove the manual gearbox. In the incident had occurred 2 days ago, the mechanical repairman had worn special clothes and breathing apparatus to install the blind flange. On the day of the accident, although one of the operators warned about opening the manual gearbox, other people thought that the valve was leaking 2 days ago, and the pressure before and after the valve was the same, so removing the manual gearbox was not dangerous. The repairman had to move up 2 threads of the valve to remove the manual gearbox. By opening the discharge valve and removing the manual gearbox, the valve suddenly opened completely due to the back pressure. This incident indicated that the operator's perception was wrong, because if the pressure on both sides of the valve was the same, the disc would not move upwards. Unfortunately, the observation of this incident did not cause to stop the operation, and it was thought that the blind flange is reliable enough. After this, the repairman tried to open the manual gearbox of the suction valve. After turning the hand wheel of the gearbox, the valve suddenly opened and the high temperature and high pressure liquid hit the non-standard blind flange and caused leakage. These blind flanges were handmade, and not only it was not possible to be fully bolted, but also it was not properly placed in the flange. No one could stand against toxic liquid with a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 10 bar to close the valve.